Hello friends, in this session we will talk about the cycle of life, cycle of step. So I am giving you the one example. Just suppose we all organism reach at the age of the puberty, and now we will reach to the age of the marriage, and again we will produce the another organism just like us, and this organism now again will grow, and he will or she will make the newer organisms, and this cycle will be again and again repeated, and as a result we humans are there on this earth. In the same way we have the cell cycle in our body. Just suppose we talk about the cells, then cell will be at the specific age. Just suppose cell is age of the right now 1 hour. Cell have the only age of the 1 hour, then the cell will start to grow and it will be converted into the mature cell. Now the cell again will reproduce and it will be divided into two another cell. So these two another cell again will grow and it will be reached at the age of the 1 hour. Again they will reproduce, again they will mature, again they will reproduce, again they will mature, and the cycle will be repeated. So in this session of the lecture we will talk about the cell cycle, the cycle of the cells that is present in our body, how we are alive. Just suppose I am talking about our cells. If we touch anywhere, then our cell will be lost. To recover this loss of the cell, what we have to do? We have to make the newer one cell. Just suppose we use the oil in our bike or the car, then this oil will be used and it is get black. Okay, so what we have to do? We have to replace this oil after the some time. After the 6 month or the 1 year, we have to replace this used oil. We say it black oil, and we will add the newer oil. So this oil will again function, and after the some time, we have to replace again this oil. In the same way, if I will tell you that our cells are also used in the processes just like metabolism. And after these processes, the cell will be get died, and we have to replace the newer cell instead of that old cell. So this function will be there. So I am telling you how many phases are there of the cell. Just suppose newly synthesized cell is here. Just suppose newly synthesized cell is there. So the cell will be present over here. Now, as the cell will start to grow, so it will be past the G1 phase. G1 stands for the growth phase, growth one phase. It is also known as the gap phase. Can you hear my voice? Can you hear my voice? Okay. So, now this cell will start to grow and it will complete its first cycle of the growth. Just it will be grown. It is get mature. Now what will be happen? As I have already told you about that thing, cell have only the one copy of genome. Cell have the only one copy of the genome. Just suppose over here one cell is there, then it will have the one copy of the genome. And whenever it is get divided, just suppose two cells are get formed, so cell is get confused. Whom I have to give this copy? Just suppose if one copy is transferred to this cell only, then this cell doesn't have the copy of genome. So cell have to replicate the genome. Cell have to duplicate this genome. The cell first will try to make the two copy of gene, two copy of DNA, and now this will transfer to the every cell that is formed from the old cell or the parent cell. So this replication of DNA, duplication, Xerox copy of DNA is performed in this phase. It is known as the synthetic phase. So in the synthetic phase, the copy of the DNA will be there. So if I will ask you the one question, how many number of the copies are present in the G1 phase, then obviously you have to tell me one copy. And just suppose I am asking you how many number of the copies are after the synthetic phase, then obviously two copies are there. Now what's happened? After this synthetic phase, the cell again maturing. So after the maturing second time, the cell is ready to divide now. So again, in the, just suppose I am talking about the G1 phase. So what is happened in the case of the G1 phase, the cell is trying to be mature enough to replicate its genome. So in the G1 phase here, this procedures or several precautions for the replications will be taken up. And after the synthetic phase, the cell have the two copy of the genome. Now the cell will be transferred into the G2 phase. So in the growth 2 phase, it will again prepare for the division. So now it is ready for the division. And in the M phase, it is known as the mitosis phase, the cell will be exactly divided and two number of cells are produced. So in the different way, again I am explaining same figure. Just suppose after the mitosis, one number of cell is there. This one number of cell will have the one number of the genome over here. So it will have the one number of genome over here. Now what happened? It is again collecting several enzymes in this phase. Okay, so here is the genome. And the cell is collecting the several materials for the division. So I am again drawing over here several materials, just like the enzymes. So enzymes will come over here. So these enzymes will help in the replication processes. Now what happened? It is transferred to the synthetic phase. So in the synthetic phase, the replication of genome is performed. So one cell will be there. Number of the genome copy will be duplicated. So two copy will be there. And this blue colored material is already utilized. So I am not again drawing over here. In the case of the G2 phase, what is happened? In the case of the G2 phase, cell is again preparing. Cell is preparing for the division. So it obviously has the two copy of the genome will be there over here. And these two copy of the genome again will be start for the condensing. So condensation will be start. They will try to make the chromosome again. So this all genome, whatever I have drawn in the yellow color, will be scattered randomly. So just suppose here one copy is there, so it will be there scattered. Again one copy is here, so it will be again scattered. Two copy are there, then again they will be scattered. They will obviously attach, but they will be scattered. So this genome could not be observed properly by the microscope because this genome is scattered. Where bikhe thailu hoy. So it could not be observed properly by the microscope. So during the growth of the cell, we could not observe chromosomes properly. So only in the mitosis phase, these chromosomes will be observed. So in the G2 phase, these chromosomes are start to condense, mean they will come together, they will attach with one another, and as a result, after the growth phase only, these chromosomes will start to be appear. And after this, in the mitosis phase, what is happened in the case of the mitosis, two number of cells will be formed. Okay, so one is over here, one is over here, and the exactly the number of the DNA will be exactly same, but again after it is again scattered. Okay, so it could not be again visualized. If you want to visualize the chromosome and the genetic material, then we have to focus after the G2 phase on this cell. Just suppose in this mitosis phase I am focusing upon these cells, then and then only I can visualize. Okay, so in this phase I can visualize the genetic material as a chromosome in this way. So I hope you get it, this point. Now I am again moving further. Just suppose if anyone is growing, then this organism must have the two conditions. This growth is achieved whether by the division, means just suppose one cell is there, then it will be divided, so two number of cell will be there. So it is known as the growth. Growth defined as the increaseness in the number of the cells. So just suppose we were baby and at that time the number of cells were much lower. After that, now the number of the cells have been increased, so it will be known as the growth. The another method of the growth is the deposition of the cellular material. Another method of the growth is the deposition of the cellular material. So our cell will excrete several material. Our cell will excrete several material, just like the carbohydrates, proteins, and this will be accumulated in our body. So these materials will be accumulated in the body. I am giving you example, just like we have the village, and in this village the only 5 people are living nowadays, and after the growth they will reproduce and the number of the people are the 50. So we can say it as the growth. If I am telling you the same example with the deposition of cellular material, then what will these 5 people do? These 5 people will grow, they will use the several materials, and these materials will be deposited in their village. So the matter, some materials will be gathered in the village, and as a result this village have the more size. So in the same way, cell will use several materials, it will accumulate, it will deposit some materials outside of the cell and inside of the cell. So size of cell again will be grown. Okay, so if I am telling you the growth, just suppose over here the one cell with the lower size, and after the accumulation of the materials, the cell will have the more size. So this will be also known as the growth. In the another thing, if the size of the cell is remain same, but if cell deposit the material outside the cell, then this material again will occupy the much space in the body. So body will now take the more space. Okay, so this is the why we are getting big and large as with the age. Now, how many type of the divisions are there in this entire world? Okay, whether they are the living organism, if they are the animal, if they are the plant, then only and only generally 3 type of the divisions are there. One is found in the bacteria, it means prokaryotes. So this will be found in the prokaryotes, and something that will be found in the eukaryotes, mitosis and the meiosis will be found in the eukaryotic organism. So 3 phases are there. So 3 phases are there. In this 3 phase, the division of the cell is occurred. In these 3 phases, the division of cell is performed. So if I am talking about the binary fission, so what? Cell is divided, just divided. It divides the chromosomal material, it is known as the genetic material of bacteria, and cell will be divided. So there will not be requirement of the much and more equipment. But in the case of the mitosis or the meiosis, the special requirements will be there, equipment will be needed, because we have to divide this cell into 2 equal cells. We have to divide it in the 2 equal cells, so several equipments will be required. So in the further slides we are moving towards them. So some questions in our brain will be again arise: which cell will divide and which will not divide? Okay, so all cells can divide except the quiescent cell, except the cells, they are the quiescent, and some cells they are senescent. So only 2 type of cells that could not divide. One is the quiescent cell. Quiescent, it means that the cell, they are in the resting period. So in the resting period, the cell could not be divided. So in the resting period, this cell will not divide. And some cells, they have the senescent. Senescent means that the cells already have been reached to the age, or they have the specific function. Just suppose we have divided some cells and we have given them specific function. Now just suppose one cell is produced in our body, and this cell is said that what you have to do, you have to function to just sweating. Our skin cells will have only and only one function. What they will do? They will produce the sweat from the skin. per se. So they have this specific function, and this cells with this specific function will be known as the differentiated cell. It is known as the senescent cell. So the senescent cell will not grow, will not divide, and the quiescent cell means the resting period of the cell. Generally, the all of maximum portion of our cells are in the senescent phase, because they have already differentiated, they have the specific function. So this cell will not grow. Another are the quiescent cells, mean newly reproduced cell. Just suppose our body have produced the newly some cell, and this cell have not any function right now. If the cells have not function right now, so this cell will be known as the quiescent cell. Just suppose right now some cell have been produced, and we don't need this cell right now. We have just backup. We have produced the backup. So this cell are not needed now. So this cell again will not be grow, because they are not required right now. Okay. And if this is not maintained properly, if this cell cycle, if the cells are not moving into the quiescent phase, and if the cells are not moving in the senescent phase, then several irregularities are formed. Uncontrolled cell growth is formed, and as a result, tumor also can be formed. Now, one question is again there: how many type of the cell are there in the body? If we talk about the division, so there are the three type of the cells in our body. Are there germ cells, stem cell, and somatic cells? So first of all, what is germ cell? From these germ cells, gametes are produced. Means sperm and ovum are produced. So the sperm and ovum will be produced from the germ cell by the process of meiosis. So it is the process of the meiosis. Okay. And if stem cells are there, then the stem cells have the ability to make the any type of the cell of our body. If we have the one stem cell, then we can make the entire body. So these abilities stem cell possesses. So the stem cell will be divided by the mitosis, and it will make the so many number of the copies in the body. So this germ cell also can be divided, and it can be divided by the meiosis process. If we talk about the stem cell, then stem cell also can be divided, and the stem cell can be divided by the mitosis. And we have the somatic cell. Somatic cell mean that whatever the differentiated cell in our body, just suppose we have the differentiated cell in our body, we can also say the senescent cell. Just suppose the cell of the skin, cell of the bone, cell of the eyes, so this will be known as the somatic cells. And some of the somatic cells also can be divided. Okay. And they will be also divided by the mitosis. So in our body, every time mitosis will be present, and meiosis only will be present if we want to form the gametes only. So just suppose we want to form the gametes, then we need the germ cell. And if we don't want to make gametes, then we don't need the meiosis. Here is the representation of the cell cycle. First, every cell will come into the G1 phase. After the G1 phase, it will move into the synthetic phase, and after the synthetic, it will move into the G2 phase, growth 2 phase, and after that, it will move into the mitosis phase. Now, the entire period after the mitosis and to mitosis is known as the interphase. It is known as the interphase. Just suppose I am telling you the all phases, including G1, synthetic, and G2, this all will be known as the interphase. And it will be known as the interphase, and remaining portion will be known as the mitotic phase. It is known as the mitotic phase. So two phases are there, one is interphase and second one is the mitotic phase. Interphase have the three phases. One is G1, second is S, and third is the G2 phase. Okay. G2 is also known as the growth 2 phase. G1 is also known as the growth 1 phase. This both can be termed just like the gap one phase and gap two phase, and it can also be said the group one, growth one phase and growth two phase. Just suppose some cell have the ability, just suppose some cell don't want to divide now. They just reproduce and they are here and they are not going to divide. So this cell will be arrested at the G1 phase. Mean in the G1 phase they will not move further. Just suppose here G1 phase is there, and in this G1 some cell don't want to grow, they will not be grow, they will not be sent to the synthetic phase. So this type of cell will be arrested in the G1, and these cells are known as the G0 phase, G0 phase. So these cells are arrested at the G0 phase. They will be saved at the G0 phase. Okay. So they will not further moving into G1 and S phase. So they are arrested in the G0 phase or the G0 phase. Now here we have the again some information. Just suppose resting period. What is the resting period? So in the resting period, there is the only one phase, and this is the G0 phase, G0 phase. Okay, in this phase, the cell left the cycle. Okay, it will not again perform the cycle, and it is stopped dividing. Okay, so it is known as the G0 resting period. In the G1 phase, it is known as the gap one or the growth one phase. In this, it will check whether cell is ready for DNA synthesis or not. So it is just checkpoint whether cell is ready for the DNA synthesis or not. It is just the checkpoint. It is check whether this is ready for the DNA synthesis or not. Then after we have the synthetic phase. Then after we have the synthetic phase. In this phase, cell will duplicate its genetic material. It will duplicate, mean it will make the copy, and after the copy, cell will have the two number of copy, okay, of genetic material. After the cell have been copied genetic material, it will again grow, okay. And now in this growth, cell will check whether it is ready for the mitosis or not. So in this phase, cell just want to check whether it is ready for the mitosis or not. Okay, so in this phase, it is the function of the cell. And after it, after this G1 synthetic and G2 phase, cell will be moving into the mitotic phase. And in this phase, again, cell will be divided by the mitosis. Okay, and two daughter cells will be formed. Two cells will be formed over here. In the mitosis, again cell have to check something. In the mitosis, again cell have to check something. What cell will check? In this phase, cell will check. We have already divided the two nucleus. Just suppose two cell is formed. Okay, so they have divided the nucleus. So two copy of genome will be here. Okay, so now cell will check whether they are ready to divide. So then after only it will be divided, separated. Okay, so these are the different phases. Now, as we know that this must be regulated. If every cell want to divide and everything will be divided, then it will generate several problems. So overcome these problems, we have the specific mechanism in our cell for the control system. We will also check tell it as the regulatory mechanism. So we are also studying the regulatory mechanism, mean how this is entire managing properly. So we have the two proteins, two type of the proteins are there. One is the cyclins, one are the cyclins, and another are the cyclin activated kinases. Two type of proteins are there. Two type of mechanism are. One is the cyclin. Okay, and second thing is the cyclin dependent kinases. So it is known as the CDKs. So we have to remember only and only two things. One is the cyclin and another is the cyclin dependent proteins. Cyclin dependent protein mean the CDK. Okay, so two type of mechanisms are there, CDKs and the cyclins. They have the specific function, and in this lecture we are also talking about that thing also. Regard with the cyclin and the CDK proteins, we have the checkpoint also. Means we will check at the every phase of the growth. In the G1 phase, we will check whether it is ready for DNA synthesis. In the synthetic phase, we will check whether it is ready for the growth 2 phase. In the G2 phase, we will check whether it is ready for the mitosis. And after the mitosis, in the mitosis, we will check whether the cell is ready for the division. Okay, whether it is ready to be an individual cell. So everywhere we will check whether it is ready or not, and it is known as the checkpoint. So cell have the so many checkpoints also, and cell have this several proteins, they are regulating this mechanism. Okay, so cyclins and the CDK proteins are there. CDKs are the kinase proteins. CDK are the kinase protein, and kinase mean whatever the protein, whatever the enzyme have the ability to phosphorylating something. So just suppose here is some material is there or some enzyme is there, and if this kinase protein is adding phosphorus to this enzyme, then this protein will be known as the kinase. This enzyme will be known as the kinase. So kinase is the family of the enzyme, and it have the function to phosphorylate the protein. And as this kinase is phosphorylating these enzymes, now this enzyme will function for the cell division. Mean all the activities of cell division are out by enzymes, and these enzymes are activated by phosphorylation, mean the addition of the phosphorus. And this phosphorylation is carried out by the kinases, and these kinases are activated by the cyclins. Okay, so cyclins have the ability to control every mechanism of cell, and specifically cell division. We have one example of this regulation. It is known as the retinoblastoma gene. It is also known as the RB1 gene. It is also known as the RB1 gene. So here in the mechanism of this RB protein, if this RB protein is active, then it will inactivate E2F protein. So as this E2F protein is inactivated, then the cell could not move. The cell could not move for the division or the DNA synthesis. What is the role of the E2F protein? E2F protein will send the positive feedback, mean this protein will say that yes, everything is fine and you should go for the division. But if this is unactivated, if it is deactivated by the retinoma RB1 protein, then the signals could not be reached further and process will be stopped. So what is happening here? If the retinoblastoma 1 gene is inactivated, then what happened? This protein E2F is activated, and as the E2F protein is activated, cell will move for the division. Again, I am repeating, if RB1 protein is activated, then it will inactivate the RB1 protein. As this protein is inactivated, it could not bind to the E2F protein. As it could not bind to the E2F protein, this E2F protein will be now active, and this E2F active protein will send signal to the CDK and cyclins. It will send the signals to the CDKs and the cyclins S protein, and again cell cycle will be move further. So by the inactivation of one gene or one protein, by the inactivation of one gene or one protein, the cell will divide rapidly, and rapidly divided cell will generate the one tumor. We can say it as the cancer, and this cancer is known as the retinoblastoma. This cancer is known as the retinoblastoma. So why this retinoblastoma is formed? This retinoblastoma is formed by the inactivation of the retinoblastoma gene. This protein is again inactivated. If this protein is inactivated, then E2F protein will be activated. As this E2F protein is activated, this E2F will send the signal for the division, and as a result, cell will be now carcinogen, and it will be moved towards the tumor of cancer. So it was the one mechanism. Okay, we have to study only two mechanisms of the regulation, because one was the RB1 gene that was responsible for the retinoblastoma, and second one is the P53 protein. Okay, it is again much important. Can you hear my voice? Kindly send your response. Can you hear my voice properly? Okay. And are you getting my point? Could you understand it? Okay. Again, I have recorded this video, so I will send you. Again, you can repeat same thing. Okay. And I am already available for you, so you can ask me every time. Now, the second mechanism is of the P53 protein. In the P53 protein, what is happening? I have already told you about the check system. Check system means check post. Just suppose somebody is suffering from the corona and he have the fever, and if he or she is entering in the border, then what will be there? There will be one person with this thermal scanner. Okay, so he will scan the person with the thermal scanner machine, and whether he is found more temperature than 99, then he will pause. He will stop this person from entering into the border. Okay, so in the same way, cell have the same system. Whether cell have not been copied the genetic material, what cell have to do? Cell have to copy the genetic material in the synthetic phase over here. And just suppose cell have not synthesized the genetic material, cell have not duplicated this genetic material, then this cell could not enter into G2 phase. Our check system will refuse, our cell system will refuse this mechanism for the division. So how this is refused? This is refused by sending the signal to the P53 protein. Just suppose division is there, and during the division nutrition deficiency is found. During the division, if nutritional deficiency is found, just suppose we cell doesn't have the much amount of the nutrition, so cell will refuse that I am not ready for the division, first I need the nutrients. If DNA is get damaged, then cell also will refuse that I could not right now divide because my genome is already damaged, and first I have to repair it, and then after I will move towards the division. Just suppose some oxidative stress are there, some hormones are there. So there are so many mechanisms, so many reasons for the pause or arrestation of this mechanism. So here in the figure at this portion, this protein will send the signal to stop this mechanism. This protein, if DNA is damaged, then this protein will be activated. You have to remember this thing. If in the case of the retinoblastoma, RB1 protein was inactivated, but in the case of the P53, it is activated. So P53 protein will be activated. In which conditions P53 will be activated? Whether the DNA have the damage or it have the nutrient deficiency. So P53 is activated, and now this activated P53 will send the signal to repair this DNA, to autophagy, mean to eat the cell, own cell. It will also send the metabolic switches. It will also send dormancy. So several signals will be sent, and at that time, whenever it is going for the checking of that problem, the cell cycle is get arrested. Arrested means at that time the cell cycle is get paused, mean during that time the cell cycle will not be moved further. So cell will not divide during that time. It is also, there are some options, just like the apoptosis. Apoptosis means the programmed cell death, means cell will be killed itself. Several other options are also there. So it is the example how our cell division is controlled. Okay, so this is the mechanism of how this is controlled. Okay, now we have the little portion in the cell cycle, and then after we will moving for the cell division. Okay, how this cell will refuse for division if it have not replicated its genome properly? You already know that cell have to divide every time, but one scientist have performed one experiment. Name of scientist was the Hayflick. Hayflick have performed one experiment, and in that experiment what he have did, he took the one cell and he performed he grown the cell in the cell line culture. So after some cycles, the cell have stopped, arrested for the division. Means cell have not divided for much time. Just suppose I am telling you one example. If we take the bacterial culture and we grow them into the petri plate, then bacteria will grow every time. I mean they will not stop. Okay, every time they will be grown. But in this case, what is happening? Cell will be refused for the division. Mean after, just suppose one cycle have been completed, two have been completed, three have been completed, four have been completed. So in, after the first cycle, two cell will be formed. After the second cycle, four number of cell, eight number of cell, 16 cells will be formed. Okay, and after that, just suppose cell have refused to divide. Okay, why cell have refused to divide? Cell have refused to divide because every time the cell is replicating, during that process, the some portion of this DNA that is shown in the green color, the end of the chromosome, it is made up of the telomere. This portion is exited. This portion is already cut down, and due to this cut down, due to the not replication, this portion is not present in DNA after the several cycles, and it, this mechanism is known as the replicative senescence. Mean after the some cycle, cell doesn't have the telomeric portion of the chromosome, and it is the reason why the cell is refusing to divide more. In our body also same mechanism is applied. Just suppose we have the age of 40 years, then our cell can divide because it have the this telomeric portion. But after the age of the 70, 80 or 100, this telomeric portion is not there. In Gujarati we can say ghasai gayo, and it is the reason why after 100 years we could not live. It is known as the programmed cell death. Karachaliyo padi jai sarir ma. So that type of the problems arise as this telomeric portion is not present. several proteins that are produced by the telomere protein, telomere gene. This telomere is present in the DNA, and as this DNA will make the gene, and as this gene will convert it into the several proteins, and these proteins are responsible for the checkpoint. These proteins are responsible for the checkpoint. They will check whether this protein is formed. Yes, this protein is formed. Then and then only it will be replicated, it will be divided. And if this telomeric portion is not there, telosome will not be formed. And as a result, the replicative senescence will be there, and cell will not again divide. And this arrestation of division is known as the Hayflick limit, because he have discovered why the cells are not dividing furthermore. One thing is the uncontrolled growth and the cancer. Why this cancer is formed? Generally, normal cell will function, will perform several activities. One is the division, mean cell will divide. Okay, it is simple. It will differentiate, mean it several function will be given. Just suppose in our classroom, there are 30 students are there. Then if we want to arrange the one function, so what will we do? We will tell that Ashish will do this work, Hitakshi will do this work, Ayushi will do this work, Riddhi will do this work. Okay, so in this manner, everyone will be provided one function, one work. Exactly, mean someone have to do this, someone have to do this. In the body also, our body have differentiated the cells for the specific function. So every cell have the one function. So it is the also the part of the normal cell. Mean normal cell will divide, it will give the specific function to the every cell, and it will be killed after the age. Now, if this normal cell is lost this usual control, then it will become the tumor. Just suppose it is regulated, uncontrolled, if it is not differentiated, if it is not killed at the specific time, then it will be converted into the tumor cell, and as a result, cancer is formed. There are two type of the cancer is there. One is the benign cancer or the benign cancer or benign tumor, and another is the malignant tumor or malignant cancer. Okay, so both have the different abilities. Just suppose we talk about the benign, then this benign tumor have not much efficiency for problems in the body, but if the malignant tumor is there, then it have the abilities to harm the another tissues also. Just suppose I am talking about the one cancer, just suppose breast cancer is there, the specific portion the tumor is formed in the breast. But if this tumor can move, and it will be moved towards the another cells, and if this cell is infecting the another portion of the body, then it is known as the malignant tumor, and this can generate several problems. It is known as the cancer. Okay, so in the case of the cancer, we have to take the several precautions. What is the cause of the cancer? Cause of cancer is cancer critical gene, CCG. It is known as the CC gene. Okay, G-E-N-E, CCG. A cancer critical genes. This cancer critical genes have again the two types. One is the activation genes, and another is the inactivation gene. Mean, if some genes are activated, then cancer will be formed. And if some genes are inactivated, then this problem will be formed. Just suppose one gene is the oncogene. And if oncogenes are activated, then cancer will be formed in our body. And if tumor suppressing gene, if tumor suppressing gene are inactivated, then cancer can be caused. So cancer is the cause of DNA. It is not disease that is spreaded by the bacteria. Okay, some viral cancers are also there. This virus will transfer the oncogenes from one body to another body. So this is the disease of genes. If regulation is not proper, then cancer can be caused. Okay, and this is by our diet, the environmental functions also. This is the danger. Okay, I mean if something is the carcinogenic, then this function, image will be there. This in the specific area, just suppose there will be the carcinogen, then it is shown over there. लेड, आर्सेनिक, बेंजीन, नाइट्रस ऑक्साइड इन अवर डाइट, जस्ट लाइक द इंसेक्टिसाइड्स, हर्बिसाइड्स, सो दे ऑल्सो पजेस द कार्सिनोजेनिक एक्टिविटी. यूवी रेडिएशन, एक्सरे रेडिएशन, दे आर ऑल्सो द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द कार्सिनोजेंस. Our well-known scientist Rosalind Franklin also died due to the cancer, due to the X-ray crystallography procedures. He have allowed, he have exposure with the X-rays, and due to that reason, he met to the cancer. Now, first I am pausing over here the first period.